Hi everyone! Welcome back to integralcalc.com. Today we're going to be talking about how to find derivatives of inverse hyperbolic functions. And in this particular problem, we've been given the function f of x equals the inverse hyperbolic sine function of x raised to the 3/2 power. So in this particular case, we're going to need to use chain rule to get the derivative. So we'll call the derivative, of course, f prime of x. When we're talking about chain rule, we've got an outside function here, which is basically something raised to the 3/2 power. And then we have an inside function, which is just the inverse hyperbolic sine function of x. So taking the derivative of the outer function first, we will multiply this 3/2 exponent out in front. So we'll get 3/2. And according to chain rule, we take the derivative of the outside function, leaving the inside function completely alone, and then deal with the derivative of the inside. So we're not going to deal with the inverse hyperbolic sine function right now. We're just going to leave that as it is. But we multiplied this 3/2 out in front, and now we need to subtract 1 from the exponent. So 3/2 minus 1 is 1/2. So that is the derivative of the outside function. But now, according to chain rule, we need to multiply by the derivative of the inside function. So the derivative of the inverse hyperbolic sine function is defined by this formula, which is equal to 1 over the square root of 1 plus x. So that means that we need to multiply here by 1 over the square root of 1 plus x, or 1 plus x squared, sorry. And this is now our full derivative because we've taken the derivative of the outside function and the inside function, and now we just need to simplify this. So what we get is in the numerator, we've got 3 in the numerator, and we also have the inverse hyperbolic sine function of x raised to the 1/2 power, which is the same thing as saying the square root of the inverse hyperbolic sine function. Raising anything to the 1/2 power is the same thing as taking the square root of that. So we end up with the square root on top, and then in the denominator, we just have 2 times the square root of 1 plus x squared. Those are the two pieces that we have in our denominator. And that's it. That is our derivative. So taking the derivatives and integrals of inverse hyperbolic functions is largely about knowing the formulas that give you the definitions of those things. But once you have them, if you can either derive them or you can memorize them, this will make your life a lot easier. But I just wanted to give you guys an example of how you would use this in a real problem and kind of paired it with chain rule. So I hope that video helped you guys, and I will see you in the next one.